Affordable versus expensive art supply. Affordable versus expensive art supply. But if I get lonely, I'ma need your help. Pay attention to me, I don't talk for my health.
I want you on my team.
So does everybody else.
Baby, we can keep it on the low. Let your guard down, ain't nobody got it on. If you were the girl, I know a place we can go.
What kind of girl do you take me for?
Okay, if you're asking if it was a necessary purchase, I don't really have an answer for you, buddy. But if you're asking if I think everybody on this planet just needs one of them,
wait till the end.
Answer's a little obvious.
If you love art, you need to get one of this. Flip open. Ooh, a brush. What's this? Now we have brushes. Wow. One for painting and another one is to clean brushes. Genius. Some of the watercolor paintings I did using this.
I just received some new brush paint markers, which I've never had before, and I highly recommend them actually. These pens are so vibrant, I've never had colors that pop out so much. It looks great on both white and black paper, it's amazing.
So a lot of you guys asked what supplies I use. So I'm going to tell you all the supplies I use in my drawings and paintings.
People ask me all the time, where did I get my pen and why don't you use a regular pen? I got my pen off of Amazon. It's a Mole Shine glass dip pen, and besides the fact that it is so freaking gorgeous that it makes doing art so much more fun, the main reason I bought this pen is because one dip in my ink pot lasts so long. It can hold so much ink. So here's a clip of me drawing with just one dip in my ink pot. You guys, it is so incredible. Then I had to refill before I could continue on with my drawing. Another reason I love this pen is because you can draw from a bunch of different angles and the ink still flows from the pen relatively the same way. I love my glass dip pen. I love it.
Hey, do you like tiny things? Well, how about some tiny art supplies? The boss bought these little packs thinking that they were actually full size, but look, tiny colored pencils, tiny eraser, tiny pencil sharpener. I knew I had to make some art with this, so I grabbed some Bristol Artist trading cards, and I taped it down, and it looks hilariously small. I wanted to use as many colors as possible, and this is my account after all, so of course I decided to draw a toucan. I took to Google, got a reference, and got started. If I was to actually, like, review these pencils, I'd say I was surprised by how pigmented they were, but it was really difficult to sharpen them, like the sharpener is garbage. I also didn't really use the eraser. I don't really erase colored pencils, usually. So there's that. But like, look how cute it is. It's so tiny. Okay, and yeah, I was a little surprised at how cute it came out. So let me know if you want to see more tiny art and toucan.
Today we're going to be talking about must-have products for artists. For storing supplies, you can either use large tackle boxes or makeup carriers. This one's old. It's what I used to use, but it's got one of these foldy thingies.
Next is any type of marker, pencil, brush holder like this one that you can get on Amazon. I like these because it's a great way to organize them without damaging like the bristles of your brush. I used to set all my brushes out in like a drawer and I'd have to sift through them to see them. And this way I can see all my brushes and I can organize them by brush type. Next is something I actually bought because I saw it on TikTok, and it's the Hemi Gouache set. I love this. It's not that expensive. And for a first time gouache user, I have had no complaints. I'm not great at gouache, so I couldn't say if it was the best type of gouache you could get, but I personally really like it, and it comes in a really cute packaging. This one's kind of random and also extremely specific. It's just this brush set. I had it gifted to me and I love it. I probably use these brushes more often than any of my other brushes. I just really like them.
So when tower. The way we did that too, she thinks it's special. But it's all reused, that was our place. I found it first, I made the jokes. You tell to her when she's with you. Do you get deja vu when she's with you? Do you get deja vu?
So by now we all know about the Hemi gouache. But let's talk about a new one that I found that is very similar. This Art X set of gouache. And what's really special about this one is the color palette that comes with it. But it essentially looks the same in terms of packaging as the Hemi gouache. You can see that it's the same jelly cups and they open the same way. These are a little easier to open than the Hemi gouache in my opinion. Now we're getting into the color palette. You can see that this set in particular has a lot of pastels and has a lot of unique colors, like some cool greens and some really nice pastel purples. I'm really excited to get started with this set. I'll put the link in the comments, but comment what you guys think of this set.
You need to fall in love with your paintbrushes, your paper too, and your paints. You need to get to know them like you would a new friend. You need to give yourself time to play with these new friends. Push them to their limits and see what they produce when you barely touch them to the paper. Bounce them across the surface, tap, squiggle, be a complete goofball with your brushes. If you take getting to know them too seriously, they won't reveal as much of themselves to you. So fill up pages with crazy marks and just be ready to be shown a whole new world. Happy painting.
Affordable art supplies that help you save money. Aspire Color Edition. This is the 80 pack of alcohol-based markers by Aspire Color. They have an amazing selection of grays and skin tones along with a blender. They also include a carrying pouch and a fine tip pen. Overall, this is a great alternative to the more expensive brands.
Art supplies I wish I knew about years ago, part 4. And they're these tiny little needlepoint applicator bottles. Sorry, I just get really excited about art supplies.
Oh, got in my hair.
So for this example, I just put some like acrylic ink in there. And if you're practicing social distancing, like you can hit it from a distance.
Ooh, that was more aggressive than y'all sliding into my DMs.
Or if you want to be more specific and do like little lines and whatnot.
Sometime it do be dripping. Sometimes we like to dot it up.
It doesn't have to be ink. You can throw in water, alcohol, anything that does something, masking fluid. They also come with these little banded tops, so like it won't dry out in there either.
And you don't even have to worry about job applications because these applicators are cheap as hell. They're like $1 each, if that. Anyways, if you like this series, just let me know in the comments and I'll just keep doing them.
If you're still here, watch it again.
This is the coolest thing I've bought from Amazon.